1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 20. But now is Yahweh Shai risen from the dead and become the first fruits of them that slept. For since by man came death, by man came also the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all died, even so in the Mashiach shall all be made alive. But every man in his own order, Yahweh Shai, the first fruits, afterward, they that are Mashiachs at his coming. Then cometh the end, when he shall have delivered up the kingdom to the Most High, even the Father, when he shall have put down all rule and authority and power, for he must reign till he have put all enemies under his feet. Brock the Yahweh, Brock the Yahweh Shai, 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 Yahweh Vashim Yahweh Shai, Vashim Kogadash, Brock a Thumb, to the Akim out there that's preaching this word of sincerity and the truth. And double honors to the elder apostles of Great Millstone who taught us this truth. And in today's lesson, I'm going to get into Yahweh Shai coming to get his glory on the earth. The Father Yahweh set an appointed time for wickedness to reign on the earth, which wickedness is being brought forth by Esau, the so-called white man. He is the wicked that the Bible speaks of. He is the physical counterpart to the spiritual demon Satan on the earth. And through his rulership, wickedness is throughout the earth, breaking the Heavenly Father's laws, statutes, and commandments is throughout the earth because of Esau, the so-called white man. So Yahweh Shai, the Heavenly Father's son, is coming back to set up righteousness in the world based upon wickedness. And this was the plan of the Father from the beginning, for us to fall as a nation, being the sons of God, and for wickedness to reign, which power was given to them by the Most High to fulfill the will on the left-hand side, and for ultimately the Lord to bring us back to his glory, to righteousness, and for his son, Yahweh Shai, to reign forever. So we're living in prophecy. We're living out the prophecies of Yahweh Shai. This is 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 20. But now is Yahweh Shai risen from the dead and became the first fruits of them that slept. Because Yahweh Shai is known as what? The only begotten son. He was the first spirit created by his father Yahweh. And he had the taste of death by going on that cross to take on the sins of Israel, starting with the elect, so that we can be adopted back as the sons of the Most High once again. So he is the first fruits of them that slept. He is the first, the foundation. He is the spirit that's going to bring us life, which is what him coming with that new covenant, them new bodies, us receiving that heart of flesh. 1 Corinthians 15 and 21. For since by man came death, by man came also the resurrection of the dead. For as Adam all died, even so in the Mashiach shall all be made alive. Because Adam partook of eating of the tree of good and evil, which is what? Wickedness, which was brought to him through Eve being beguiled by the serpent, which was man going off, which brought forth what? Death. So Adam brought death in the world. That's when the Most High cut our time short, because in the beginning we were created to live forever. We were known as the sons of God. We were supposed to be immortal. But Adam brought death into the world. Even so, in the Mashiach shall all be made alive. So Yahweh Shai is coming back to bring life to the nation of Israel. By us receiving that new covenant, we're going to be joined back with Yahweh forever. We're never going to sin. We're never going to go off, which is going to bring us life, which is being brought to us by what? Yahweh Shai. Him being the ultimate sacrifice. For as Adam all died, even so in the Mashiach shall all be made alive. But every man in his own order, Yahweh Shai, the first fruits, afterward, they that are Mashiachs at his coming. Because Yahweh Shai is the first fruit. He has his body in the heavens, that immortal body that he's coming back in this realm to get his glory. But we, being joint heirs with Yahweh Shai, are going to receive that same gift. When he returns, we're going to be joint heirs with Yahweh Shai and get them what? New bodies. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 24. Then cometh the end. When the end of the world comes, when Esau, the so-called white man, loses his power on the earth that the Heavenly Father gave him to show the world what wickedness is. Then cometh the end when he shall have delivered up the kingdom to the Most High, even the Father, when he shall have put down all rule and authority and power. So when Yahweh Shai returns, he's going to put down all rule, all authority, and all power. Yahweh Shai is going to reign on this earth in him only. All the kingdoms of the earth are going to be brought down. Russia is going to be brought down. China is going to be brought down. America is going to be destroyed off the face of the earth, according to biblical prophecy. All the nations that are in power are going to be brought down, and they're going to be given as slaves and inheritance to our Lord Yahweh Shai. It says, then cometh the end. So the end is talking about what? When World War III takes place, when the end of Esau's world comes, then cometh the end when he shall have delivered up the kingdom to the Most High, even the Father, when he shall have put down all rule and all authority and power, but he must reign till he have put all enemies under his feet. And that's what Yahweh Shai is coming to do, to put all his enemies under his feet that the Father has given him. The last enemy that shall be destroyed is death. Now the last enemy is what? Death. Because what brought forth death into the world? Us going off and sinning. So what? We're going to overcome death by what? Yahweh Shai giving us the new bodies. So we're going to overcome the enemy of death. The last enemy that shall be destroyed is death. For he hath put all things under his feet. But when he shall have put all things under him, it is manifest that he is accepted, which did put all things under him. So everything on this earth is going to be put under Yahweh Shai's feet. He's going to have the rule, the authority, and the power over all things of the earth. This earth was created by him and for him. And he's coming back to get his glory, and his elect men are going to be joint heirs with him. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 28. And when all these things shall be subdued unto him, then shall the Son also himself be subject unto him that put all things under him, that the Most High may be all in all. So Yahweh is the head. The second in command is Yahweh Shai. And through Yahweh Shai, the elect. That's the order. So Yahweh's kingdom will be established on this earth through his son Yahweh Shai. Matthew chapter 6, verse 9. After this manner, therefore pray ye, our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. So the will of Yahweh is for his kingdom to be established on the earth as it is in the heavens, which is what? Perfect order. Perfect order. And that's what Yahweh Shai is coming to do, to bring perfect order to a world based upon disorder. So Esau, the so-called white man, the man of disorder, the wicked, is going to be taken out of power. And all you heathen nations are going to be taken out of power, and the kingdom will be given to Yahweh Shai. Revelation chapter 6, verse 2. And I saw, and behold, a white horse, and he that sat on him had a bow, and the crown was given unto him, and he went forth conquering and to conquer. Which is talking about Yahweh Shai coming back with the chariots of Israel. That's what the white horse represents. And I saw, and behold, a white horse, and he that sat on him had a bow, and a crown was given unto him. The Father Yahweh has given him the crown, the rule, the power, and the authority over all things. And a crown was given unto him, and he went forth conquering and to conquer. So when Yahweh Shai returns on the earth, he's going to what? Conquer and to conquer. He's going to conquer this earth. He's going to take down all the rulerships of the earth. Revelation chapter 19, verse 11. And I saw heaven open, and behold, a white horse. And he that sat upon him was called Faithful and True. In righteousness he doth judge and make war. So Yahweh Shah is coming back to conquer this earth in righteousness. He's going to make war with you nations in righteousness. He's going to come back to take his rulership of the earth. Revelation 19 and 12, his eyes were as a flame of fire, and on his head were many crowns, and he hath a name written that no man knew but he himself. And he was clothed with a vesture dipped in blood, and his name is called the Word of the Most High. Clothed with a vesture dipped in blood, because he's going to come back and do a lot of killing. Blood will be shed when Yahweh Shah returns. He's going to take the kingdom with brutal force. You nations are not going to give up your authority easily. You're going to fight. And Exodus 15 and 3 says, the Lord is a man of war. The Lord is his name. So the Heavenly Father wants you to fight. He wants you to fight so you can get conquered. Revelations 19 and 14. And the armies which were in heaven followed him upon white horses, clothed in fine linen, white and clean. The armies talk about the innumerable amount of angels that he's going to return with, and what the world calls UFOs, which they're known as what? The chariots of Israel. And the armies which were in heaven followed him upon white horses, clothed in fine linen, white and clean. Out of his mouth goeth a sharp sword, that with it he should smite the nations. What is that sharp sword? That's talking about them laser beams that's going to come out of them chariots and turn you people ashes to ashes, dust to dust. Let's get a precept. Isaiah chapter 66, verse 15. For behold, the Lord will come with fire and with his chariots like a whirlwind, to render his anger with fury and his rebuke with flames of fire. For by fire and by his sword will the Lord plead with all flesh, and the slain of the Lord shall be many. So Yahweh Shah is coming back to do what? To kill many people on the earth, to take out the wicked. So many people are going to die by the hands of Yahweh Shah, which he's also known as what? The King of Terrors. Revelations 19 and 15, out of his mouth will a sharp sword, that with it he should smite the nations, and he shall rule them with a rod of iron, and he treadeth the winepress of the fierceness and the wrath of the Almighty Yahweh. So he's coming back with the anger of his father. The scriptures say the day of vengeance burneth in his heart. He's in the heavens right now, waiting to come down and get his glory. It's just that the Heavenly Father is the only entity, the supreme power over all powers, that knows the exact date when he's going to send his son back. Not even the angels in heaven know. Not even Yahweh Shah himself knows. But we know it's close via the prophecies. Matthew's the 24th chapter gave you a list of things to look for before his return. And we're seeing everything take place. So Yahweh Shah is on his way to take all rulership, all authority, and all power away from you heathen nations, and for him to gain all rulership, all power, and all authority. And his elect, the 144,000, to be joint heirs with Yahweh Shah and get that same glory, to conquer this earth in righteousness. Revelation chapter 19, verse 16. And he hath on his vesture and on his thigh a name written, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Yahweh Shah is the king over all kings, and Yahweh Shah is the Lord over all lords. He's the second top spirit in the universe, the first spirit created by his father Yahweh, which his father Yahweh has no beginning and he has no ending. That's why he's known as the Ancient of Days. And the Ancient of Days is going to give his son all power, all rulership, and all authority. Daniel chapter 7, verse 9. I beheld till the thrones were cast down, and the Ancient of Days did sit. So this is Daniel seeing a vision. It says, I beheld till the thrones were cast down. So all power, all rulership, and authority will be cast down from these heathen nations. So Daniel was seeing a prophecy. I beheld till the thrones were cast down, and the Ancient of Days did sit, whose garment was white as snow, and the head of his hair like the pure wool. This is talking about Yahweh himself, the Father, the Most High himself. There's no power higher than the Most High. He always existed, and this is his movie playing out. It says, I beheld till the thrones were cast down, and the Ancient of Days did sit, whose garment was white as snow, and the head of his hair like the pure wool. So Yahweh wears a white garment, and his hair is like pure wool. His throne was like a fiery flame, and his wheels as burning fire. So what's that talking about? The chariots. The chariots of Israel. The actual wheels of the Heavenly Father are the vehicles that the angels travel. Daniel 7 and 10, a fiery stream issued and came forth from before him. Thousands ministered unto him, and 10,000 times 10,000 stood before him. All the holy angels praising Yahweh constantly. His judgment was set and the books were open, because this was already set before the foundation of the earth, that this story has to play out the way it's playing out. Daniel 7 and 11. I beheld then because of the voice of the great words which the horn spake. I beheld even till the beast was slain and his body destroyed and given to the burning flame. Talking about America, the destiny of America is to be given to the burning flame, to be destroyed in thermonuclear destruction. Daniel 7 and 12. As concerning the rest of the beasts, they had their dominion taken away, their glory and their rulership taken away, these other heathen nations, yet their lives were prolonged for a season and time, because they're going right into slavery. When Yahweh Shai returns, he's going to enslave all these heathen nations on the earth that don't get destroyed in World War III. Daniel 7 and 3, I saw in a night vision, and behold, one like the Son of Man came with the clouds of heaven and came to the Ancient of Days, and they brought him near before him. So this is Yahweh Shai being brought before the Father Yahweh to receive his glory, because he finished his course. He finished what the Heavenly Father sent him here to do 2,000 years ago, preaching the words of the Heavenly Father and then ultimately being the ultimate sacrifice, so the sons of the Most High can be accepted back as the sons of the Most High once again, and that we can receive what? Forgiveness of sins through the blood of Yahweh Shai. Daniel 7 and 13, I saw in a night vision, and behold, one like the Son of Man came with the clouds of heaven and came to the Ancient of Days, and they brought him near before him, and there was given him dominion and glory and a kingdom that all people, nations, and languages should serve him. Lasting dominion, which shall not pass away, and his kingdom, that which shall not be destroyed. So Yahweh Shai's kingdom is what? An everlasting kingdom. A kingdom of righteousness. A kingdom of rest. A kingdom where the nation of Israel will receive what? Paradise. This is what the Heavenly Father has planned from the beginning. For us to fall as a nation and to go off and to learn the judgments of Yahweh Shai, to receive chastisement, and for us to what? Repent and come back to him, and ultimately what? Receive salvation through his son Yahweh Shai and receive that kingdom. And that's what's coming. Daniel chapter 7 verse 27. And the kingdom and the dominion and the greatness of the kingdom under the whole heaven shall be given to the people of the saints of the Most High, whose kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and all dominions shall serve and obey him. Our kingdom is going to be everlasting. Daniel chapter 2 verse 44. And in the days of these kings shall the Most High of heaven set up a kingdom which shall never be destroyed, and the kingdom shall not be left to other people, but it shall break in pieces and consume all these kingdoms, and it shall stand forever. So Yahweh Shai's kingdom is going to stand forever, and it's going to break in pieces and consume all these kingdoms. So when Yahweh Shai returns, he's going to take down all power, all authority, and all rulership, and it's going to be given to him. Yahweh Shai will receive all power, all authority, and all rulership through his father Yahweh, and his elect men are going to be joint heirs with him. So with that, I want to give all praise and glory to him.